Steady, Layla.
Were you watching my feed? What the hell was all that?
I think that was the solution to our problem.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Desmond.
Desmond? What about him?
He was just a bartender before he joined us. Not even a very good one. And that's when he learned his real purpose. He was like a... I don't know, like a singularity. You know? A vanishing point. All of human history seemed to converge on him.
In 2012, the sun threw off a mass coronal ejection so large, it should have wrecked all life on Earth.
I remember. I worked at Abstergo then.
It was Desmond who saved us. He knew how to stop it.
Abstergo claimed credit for that. Something about their satellite network.
That's bullshit. It was Desmond. He pulled the switch that saved the world.
But that switch is still on. Still generating a magnetic field. One that's growing stronger every day.
The temple Eivor found. That's where the field originates.
Exactly. And it's been running for 8 years. Getting stronger and stronger. It'll be dangerous now. Heat, radiation...
Doesn't matter. We have to fix it. Shut it down.
No. Slow it down. It's still protecting us.
All of this is starting to make sense. Everything I've done, everything I've learned, it led me here to this moment.
You'll need the staff for this one. For protection. Otherwise, you won't make it past the first gate.
Right, of course. Okay. I'm ready.
Okay. I'll pack the van.
And I'll contact our ship. It can be in Boston Harbor by tomorrow night.
Thanks, Bex.
Surf this thing better than anyone
That's
I know.
That's not true, is it?
Well, nearly. Be careful out there. And come back in one piece.
Thanks, Bex. I'm ready.
It's a long way to Beantown. Hop in.
Sean, I'm here.
Ah, good. Your signal's already a little wobbly. Are you inside?
Not yet, but there's 100 feet of ice above me.
All right. We may lose touch when you push through, so remember what we talked about. Watch your meters carefully, for radiation especially, and keep the staff close.
Got it.
Standing by.
Zawahoe Nakwat, Unzme Burturwan di Quarde, Ul Solus Fras Hunakudide. Zum Huraz, des Dere has, Zohumsi.
I'm in.
Good. And remember, do not cut the machine off. Just blow it down. The field it generates, but still protect the Earth.
I hear you. Elevator still works.
75,000 years. What's another millennium or two?
It's getting hotter already.
Yes, by our reckoning, it's gonna go up by about 16 degrees Celsius.
How does it draw so much power?
Tectonics is our best theory. The movements of the Earth's crust, the churning lava beneath. Huge source of energy.
That's tech humans should have. Energy, not pieces of Eden. You're breaking up, Sean.
Say that again, please. You're breaking up.
Forget it. I'll call you when I'm topside.
What are you calling us when you're topside? Something like that.
Here we go. There you are. You're working overtime. Must have collapsed when the ice melted. Water from all that melted ice. Down. Don't look down. Why would anyone want to end their life here, unless they felt it was just beginning? Vasim, after 1,000 years, you're not looking so well. It's just like the Animus. It's just like the Animus. This is Eivor's Valhalla, or a simulation. So what am I looking for? Will I know it when I see it? Something feels off. Are you doing this? Are you pushing this machine to its limit?
We will never end. So here we went, in fealty to our master.
Who's your master? Is he here?
They flatter me. I am only a guest in their world. A world spun of wishes and hopes.
Basim, you sent the message. You led us to Eivor's grave.
Yes. A hopeful message, was it not?
How? You've been trapped here for a millennium. Eivor put you here.
Indeed. But I'm not alone in this place. Not always. I have a friend who helps me. Together, we read the calculations. After we located Eivor's probable resting place, I contacted you. Through the digital lattice that enwebs this earth like a spider's nest. In our day, all the world was connected like this, a superorganism of technology. The staff you carry, the temples you have visited,
I imagine you can do anything you want in this place.
Not as much as you might think. I am tethered to my body in a most uncomfortable way.
But you can slow this machine down. You know how it works.
Yes. We'll do it together. For another catastrophe is near at hand. This node of time has an ugly way of correcting itself. Go ahead.
You're a hard man to trust. You must know that.
You're not obliged to trust me. But this is all I can offer.
God damn it.
Silence, Uldur. Verdandi. Skald. Be at ease. Your day of rest has come.
At peace. At last, we rest.
Is that it? Is it done? Basim! Where are you?
What is that?
Layla. Hello.
You know me?
Yes. Through the calculations I read here in the Grey. 8 years ago, the odds of your arrival were 15,055,003,276 to 1. As the years passed by, those odds improved. And as of yesterday, near even. It's a pleasure to meet you at last.
Who are you? And what is this?
I am the reader of the calculations. All these possible futures for you and the world outside. I have spent much of my new life reading these, searching for a way to finish everything we started so long ago. It begins here. You slow down this machine and save the world, from which point all possible futures expand. Millions upon millions of possible roads. But in every one, another catastrophe recurs. The node collapses and the world is wiped out. The human race dwindles and fades. I must keep looking. I must find the solution for you. I must leave you with something.
This node. This is right now where I slow down this machine?
Yes. I start all my calculations from this point. The only thing I know for certain.
That seems limiting.
How do you mean?
What if you went back further, to 2012 when Desmond saved the world.
Desmond?
What if he didn't save the world? What if he walked away and let the world burn? Look at those timelines. Read them instead.
I see. An interesting idea. Fascinating. Billions upon billions of new timelines to explore.
Exactly. These are timelines that never came to pass, but they could have. If Desmond had let the world be destroyed, maybe the humans that survived would have learned something from the disaster. And maybe in one of those timelines, they could have found a way to prevent it from happening ever again.
That is brilliant. How did you come to that idea?
If you spend too much time narrowing down what's possible, you may never give another thought to the improbable.
Thank you for your insights, Layla.
It's only the beginning. We have a lot of data to sift through.
Are you staying?
Until we find something useful, I will. I don't want this to happen ever again.
You may not have much time, Layla. The machine is powered down, but the radiation, it will linger for decades. By my calculations, you have 73 seconds before your exposure is lethal.
I'm not worried. I have the Staff of Eden. It heals and protects.
No. You do not.
What? How? Of course.
Of course?
Fuck! All right. We'll find a solution together. However long it takes. And if that means I can never leave, so be it. I owe this to the people I hurt. The people I love.
Yes. I know the feeling.
Let's get going, huh? A few billion timelines might take a while.
It will. But it will not feel like it. That is what I like about this place.
You'll wonder where I am. You might wonder if I am. I don't know how to answer that. But I'm not afraid. And I'm not alone. We have work to do. Work that may take us days or years. It's impossible to say. But we'll finish it. What I mean is, don't come looking for me. It's too dangerous and too late. Take care of yourself. Take care of the world we still have. And take care of...
You...